Hi, today I'm looking at a wine from Greece. This is Argyros Estate's VinSanto, 4 years barrel aged from Santorini. So Santorini, an island within the Cyclades group, right in the middle of the Aegean Sea. It's a volcanic island and it makes some of Greece's best and most sought after dry wines. The island, however, also produces some fabulous sweet wines made from sun-dried grapes. These VinSantos, and particularly those from Argyros Estate, are arguably some of Greece's potentially most long-lived and highest quality, most complex wines. This particular estate was started in 1903 by Georgios Argyros, and today is run by his great-grandson, Matthew. During that period, the estate's expanded from being, I believe, about 3 acres to its current size of 65. You can be forgiven for thinking, surely I've tried this wine before on one of these videos. In fact, I bought this at an auction and had to check fairly carefully, because I know I have done a video before of a 2012 VinSanto from Argyros Estate, described as their early release wine. An early release and 4 years barrel age might perhaps mean the same thing. Maybe it's a slight relabeling, I thought. But I've done a bit of checking, and this actually appears to be a slightly different wine. Both the wines, in fact, all the Argyros VinSantos that I've looked at, have a blend made up of 80% of Assyrtiko, so the grape variety normally used for producing the crisp, dry white wines for which the island's so famous, and with the remaining 20% being made up in more or less equal proportions of two more aromatic varieties, Aidani and Athiri, with 10% of each of those completing the blend. The first place in which this wine differs from the early release wine that I've previously tasted is the fact that this wine's coming from younger vines. That's a comparative statement. This wine evidently comes, according to its label at any rate, comes from vines that are 150 years old, whereas the notes I have for the early release say that those vines are 200 years old. So it's relative youth. Vines here grow in the sandy volcanic soil, and one thing that means is that there's absolutely no phylloxera on the island of Santorini. It's not able to survive there in the very dry, barren volcanic soils that are available for it here. As a result, pretty much all the island's vines are on their own roots. Viticulture here is quite unique, in fact, in that instead of training the vines into bushes or long lines, as the plant comes out of the ground, it's trained into a basket shape or culora. And what that achieves is that it means that the grapes can grow inside this basket in conditions where they're shaded from the hot sun and protected from the breezes, which, not surprisingly, an island in the middle of the Aegean is subjected to. Once the grapes are harvested, probably in early September, they're laid out on the ground to dry. So they're on a sort of bed of pumice, so you get reflected heat. Now, the grapes are probably already relatively shriveled, but over a period of 8 to 10 days, they will desiccate further, concentrating the sugars in them, concentrating the acidity, and concentrating the flavors. Again, there are slight differences between this wine and the early release wine, whose label is actually fairly similar to this. This wine, we're told the grapes dry for 8 to 10 days. The early release, they say 10 days. So there's certainly plenty of similarity going on here. Fermentation takes place in barrel. It uses in the indigenous yeasts that have come in to the winery on the fruit. And we're told that this fermentation goes on in French oak barrels and that the wine stays in those barrels aging for 4 years to be bottled in 2015. And that's actually the biggest difference, and that's why I think that this wine is different from the early release, in that the early release is fermented in old concrete vats where it stays for 3 years before being transferred to old French and Russian oak barrels for aging for a further 4 years. So this is bottled significantly earlier than their early release wine. Technically, this wine is also slightly lower in alcohol. This is labelled as being 13% alcohol, where the early release was labelled as 13.5%, and the stats say it was 13.65%. I'm assuming that, as with the company's other VinSantos, this is likely to be incredibly sweet, probably over 200 grams per litre sugar. So let's see what we make of it, shall we? Looking at it initially, you've got a medium tawny colour there, almost a sort of a caramel sort of colour there, becoming quite amber at the rim. Swelling it, the wine has great viscosity. It's sticking to the edge of the glass quite readily and forming tears as I stop swirling there. The aromas are complex. Actually, as I was sitting here, I could smell them coming out of the glass there. They're lifted. There's a sort of a toffee and caramel. There's a sort of a honeyed sweetness, but then there's also notes of fresh mandarin orange and notes of candied peel. There's a real sort of sweetness. There's a slight high-toned aldehydic sort of note to the wine. But everything is very, very smooth, very plush. There are sort of burnt sugar notes, caramelized sugar notes, I suppose. And yes, that candied peel really sort of developing. This has had plenty of time to age under oxidative conditions in those barrels for 4 years. Possibly in relatively warm conditions as well, which will speed the aging. So let's have a taste and see. That is incredibly sweet. Gosh, you've got that sort of honeyed, treacly note at first. There's lovely freshness, actually, balancing it really quite well. But then you've always got a sort of a slight note of charcoal, just stopping the honeyed juiciness of the mid-palate from being too ebullient. There are slight touches of cedar. There are probably a hint of graphite, actually. But there is this lovely, harmonious caramel note running throughout it. Towards the end, as the acidity is showing and stopping the finish from being too cloying, actually, you start to get more of a sort of a candied peel note. And I suppose, yes, there are sort of hints of fresh orange peel there. There's a certain freshness with which the wine finishes. There is still quite a sort of a honeyed caramel note to the finish. The flavours are lasting incredibly well. I mean, this kind of wine, the producer suggests, could be aged for another 100 years. I'm not sure I'm going to be around to see if it stands the test of time, but certainly the incredible acidity that the wine has. I mean, when you look at the statistics on these, often have a pH below 3, which makes them some of the most acidic wines you'll find. But there's also a concentration. There's plenty of flavour in there to develop. Just sort of the richness, the roundness coming into the wine from the sugar is delicious. There's a lovely complexity. That is a really classy wine. So I hope you found this interesting. If you've enjoyed the tasting, do please hit the like button. Do please share it with your friends. Do consider signing up and following us on YouTube. If you've got comments, please leave them in the box below. We'd love to hear what you think either about these wines, other wines you've tried, or the videos we're making. But most importantly, I do hope you'll manage to find the time to join us to watch another video tasting at some stage in the near future. Goodbye for now.